Welcome, dear viewers, to Couch Warrior TV on YouTube. I'm the Couch Warrior, and you are watching The Passage, a Skyrim SE Let's Play featuring Ettient Jorel, the Ultmer Ranger.
Magic grows weak, and so does the barrier around our village. Time is short. Tell me what you know.
Mirak is behind what's happening to your people.
How do you know this?
I read a book in Mirak's temple and went somewhere. Mirak was there.
The legends speak of that place. Terrible battles fought at the temple. The dragons burning it to the ground in rage. They speak also of something worse than dragons buried within. Difficult to imagine, but if true, it means what I feared has come to pass. Mirak was never truly gone, and now has returned. If you could go to this place and see him, are you like Mirak? Are you dragonborn?
Yes.
Then perhaps you are connected with him. The old tales say that he too was dragonborn.
What does it mean if we're both dragonborn?
I am unsure. It may mean that you could save us. Or it may mean that you could bring about our destruction. But our time here is running out. The few of us left free of control cannot protect ourselves for much longer. You must go to Sering's Watch. Learn there the word that Mirak learned long ago. And use that knowledge on the Windstone. You may be able to break the hold our people there, and free them from control.
What will this word of power do?
Mirak is behind what is happening to our village, and so the knowledge he has gained as Dragonborn is at the heart of it. You are Dragonborn as well. You too can wield this power, perhaps to a better end.
All right.
All maker shelter.
I can't do a thing for you people. If I'm too exhausted to stand. So, we've got to get some rest. Is it another one of those creatures?
Not the best
it is. We've got to get absolutely serious about getting some rest. And given we don't know what exactly is going on around here, it would seem prudent to try and find some place to rest that's within the confines of their spell. Not sure if it's possible to sleep here in the Great Hall. I guess we could try. At this point, Ettient is just kind of registering as extreme fatigue, which is completely understandable given the circumstances. Let's see if it'll allow us to do this. It may not. Yeah. It is not going to. Let's try it anyway. Yeah. We just override that. All right, at this point, I think Ettient would probably have enough strength to eat a small amount. Guess. Let's try and sleep. See what happens. All right.
And when the world shall see. That you have forgotten.
That we might remember. Here we reclaim.
I was questioning whether or not that was going to happen if we slept within the radius of the skull's spell. Let's have a look to see if we're actually refreshed from having slept. Okay, technically we are. It's as if we've gotten a full night's sleep. But now we're in an area that's completely foreign to us. Somehow we've managed to break out of this strange spell effect.
He grows ever near to us.
No one else has.
Our eyes once were blinded.
We gotta figure out where we are.
Now through him do we see. Our hands once were idle.
Now through them does he speak.
Yet another example of Mirak flexing his muscle. Showing his power. These ash spawn are dangerous too. Ooh, ebony ore. I guess we'll take that ore. And we'll take the gold too. All right. Well, the Skull have sent us on a mission to recover a shout. Unfortunately, from a role-playing perspective, what I'm planning on doing here is that Ettient was so extremely exhausted that he really didn't have an opportunity to get directions to where he was going before completely passing out from fatigue. So at this point, we need to try and find our way back to the Skull Village somehow. People surrounding that shrine aren't going to be any help because they're all basically mesmerized. So we can't talk to them. So at this point, we're going to go on instinct. Just geographically, we understand that at the very least, the Skull Village has to be on the Snowbound. On the Snowbound side of the island, right? What am I seeing here? Giant rent in the earth. So, I think what we're going to do... Hey, wait a minute. Bodies of dead dragons. We might be on the right track. Here's a building. Let's see if we can figure out what this building is. That's not the Skull Village. Oh, there's Mirax Temple. Okay, we're seeing Mirax Temple from another angle. And another shrine. Give that shrine plenty of room. I mean, Ettient is at a point now where he has absolutely no maps at all. So, what we're going on right now is strictly a ranger's instinct, you know? Is that a skull? Those strange blue creatures are working on it. Mirak has ensnared everyone. Okay, we're getting back into the snowy regions. That's a start anyway. Oh, dead skull.
Over here. You're going to pay, outlander.
Am I?
You're on. Good on. Don't fight back. And I promise I'll kill you.
All right, we better take some action to break that sight line. All manner of new threats present themselves here. Oh, those creatures are all over the place there, too. It's fine, we'll take the long way around here. Look at our footprints, it's like Harry Potter. There's the village right there. Okay, we gotta get back in here and figure out where we need to go to help. Their spell is... they're still working it.
Put an end to this evil magic before it consumes us all. Some dark influence wields power over them, forces them to forget themselves and act against their nature. At first, it was only during the night, but now every moment is spent building some strange shrine around the windstorm. I believe if the shrine can be destroyed, the skull will be free once more.
All right.
May darkness never touch you.
Okay, let's have a look at where we're at here. Leather. All right. We're going to upgrade the skull armor. For certain. So, in order to do that, we got a... what do we got here? We got... just a necklace. And a ring at this point. Okay. And then we have our own fortify smithing potions. 44%. 6%. Let's take that. Oops. All right. Probably time well spent. This weather is horrifying. I think that the bare arms are going to present a problem, so let's take a look. Our standard armor, of course, is the mercenary armor. Comes in at 91. Skull coat, definitely not as good a protection, that's for sure. But it sure looks warm, doesn't it? Somehow that strikes me as way better. Probably warm enough that we don't need to bother with the cloak. There we go. Making it work, huh? It looks warm. All right, let's head out. Now, I don't know exactly where I'm going. I'm not going to look at the map. It's been a while since I've been here, so I'm sort of vaguely familiar with where we need to go. Dibella statue. Wow. Killed their goats. Alright, I'm not sure what we're going to run into here. If things get really nasty, we may have to find a place to hunker down and do a gear change if we want to survive it. But just in terms of roleplay, this seems like the sort of environment that Ettient may not be able to survive without this heavy weather gear. Okay, that's the shrine that he wants me to eliminate, specifically. Dangerously low on food as well now. So at this point, we're just more reliant than ever on our ranger instincts. Something is here. There's a threat. I'm just scooching over here on the side, trying to cover one flank with the cliff face. At least it's one less direction we could be attacked from. But nothing's showing up. Not hearing anything. So much ash floating in the air here. Okay, here's some kind of a trail. Steep. Okay, we're on the right track now. I'm certain of it. There are the hallmarks of a barrow. And look at these totems. These are probably those small creatures we've seen. Okay, these creatures are living in there. There's trolls up this way. Okay, do we ascend? Or do we go this way? This could be a fairly vast barrow. It looks like it gives us three directional options over this way as well. Whoa. What are we hitting? Weaklings? Must have been hunting that rabbit. Curious creatures. Okay. Ugh. Strange as they are, I do not want to mix it up with them when I'm here for another purpose. Threat neutralized. Oh, yeah. Nicely done, sir. Okay. Two visible threats neutralized. So I think what we're going to do... Got those strange creatures up over the hill, but I don't get the impression that that area is important to our search. So we've got the upper reach here and the lower portion. We'll take a look at the lower portion first. Before we do that, we're going to get in here out of the wind and I think we've got to go to the gear that's going to give us the best chance of survival in a fight. All right, let's just double check here. So if we look at our apparel, gauntlets as an example, armor of 30, 28% more damage with a bow. Gear we created most recently, the arm guards. Okay. Yeah, the stuff we're wearing is superior. So we've got the best chance of being able to defend ourselves here. A goat or a fox? Okay, this looks pretty extensive. We're going to take the hound's top-down approach. We know that this little path here is going to get us high enough, I think, that we should be able to get up across the rocks here. I'm going to stay over this side, though, because I don't want to get into any sort of additional altercation with those other creatures. Okay, this is a good overlook spot. Look. Standing upright, but giving off the signature of the dead. Holy crap. Okay, time to move. Target. For what it's worth. Alright, I think, let's do ourselves a favor. We're gonna try to squeak out any extra damage we can. Let's also be aware we've got a pretty good supply of Fortify Marksmen. They're only 60 seconds, though, so I don't want to use them until we absolutely have to. Creature's gone. Let's make a bolt here for cover. Listen. Get up in there. Yes. Not a great kill cam, but still, I'll take the kill. All right, secured some shelter. Okay, we're just anticipating there's going to be a nasty battle with this dragon. This is the highest level dragon we've fought yet. So we're going to have to move from one cover spot to another. Play it smart. This is one that we can't allow to catch us out in the open, right? Oh shit. Off the fire. Powers, shouts, what can we do here? I'm thinking Ethereal is going to be our bailout option if we get overwhelmed. Keep that stun going. Yes. Woo! Reposition, reposition, reposition. Ooh, oh my god. Go, 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 go. Stamina, don't fail me now. In the nuts. All right. He's on to us now. I think the time has come to goose our damage with some poison. Fortify marksman. I got him on that second one. Where'd he go? Gotta make him work for it, huh? Woo! All right. Okay, he's moved on. But he's going to be back. So now we change position again and make sure we are not in the same place when he comes back. Holy hell. Get into cover. Get into cover. Okay, we're hanging on, we're hanging on. Ancient dragons at master difficulty suck. Ouch, 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 ouch. Did I get him again? Damn, I can't tell. Whoo, whoo. Okay. Where'd he go? Where? Oh, wow. Okay, everybody, hang in there with me, okay? I know that in a combat situation like this, I'm all about surviving. I'm going to use whatever play style works in my favor. So understand, I zip in and out of third and first person all the time. It's how I play, so I will do what I can to keep you from getting ill, but I can't make any promises. Damage health. We'll eke out a little bit more. Okay. And then I'm thinking touch of resist fire. Couldn't hurt either. Where is he? He's out there in the open. Alright. Become ethereal is a good scouting option. Okay, here's the deal. He's out in the open. No way are we getting up in there with him. So, let's go for the high ground.
Whoa.
High ground. Where is he? Oh, man, he got right in there. Gotcha. One more. Yes. Holy. He was literally right on our ass when we made a run across there. Holy, look at that big boy. Ancient. Man. One dragon bone. He had reekling spears in him. He must have gone and attacked them. Avenging Rave. Just want my arrows back. Oh man, that was great. I feel like that was really a nice solid tactical dragon encounter. You know what I'm saying? All right, let's see if we can charge this. Okay. A little bit more juice. I'm definitely not going to waste a grand soul gem. Excuse me. Is supposedly the shout we need to know in order to break the spell. Iron Sword of Burning. Slow burning. So, the Skull have requested that we come here. Obtain this word of power. We've done that. Resist fire, we have. Eminent Magicka. Okay, the battle is over. We've got to warm ourselves up here. Now, of course, this whole concept, right, of getting warm, that's something I'm doing from a role play perspective on my own, right? That's an instance where you all, if you're playing at home and want to simulate that through a mod, that's where Frostfall would come in, because I'm fairly certain that Frostfall would view Skull Armor as probably the warmest gear that you can get in game. Troll wrecked my arrow. Hey, Rabbit, you survived the whole thing. Good for you. Okay, we're gonna see what's up this way. That one's wrecked too. Seeing here. Okay. Let's have a look at shouts as well. We've acquired this dragon soul, but we pretty much have to spend it on Bend Will. So we'll do that. There's another body down there. Okay. I don't know who they are. I'm gonna check this body though. Why are they garbed in almost nothing? And how are they killing these people? Bow out of this. It seems like the ruin continues up here over this hill, this ridge, or whatever you want to call it. But we've successfully achieved the outcome that the skull requested. There's really no reason to risk a confrontation. We really don't know what we're dealing with here. So, let's head back the same way we came so we don't get lost, I think. That would be the smart move. Let's get over here and see what kind of devastation that dragon wrought with these creatures. And they're still here. The massive stones laying around here. Clearly, it was some kind of Nordic structure at one point. They're running off down the valley. control. Structure there. Looks like a barrow here. Something else dead over there. Oh, they got a rabbit. Wow, good shot. All right. Enough messing around. Possible the Hey friend.
What do you need?
I wouldn't go over that hill if I were you. There's those blue creatures over there. Are you sure you want to do that? Hey, I don't recommend it. He's not going to listen to me. Look, I saw a whole bunch of them hanging out here. Ettient can't help but feel a little bit responsible, but he can't explain why the guy wouldn't listen to him. Maybe they've gone. That would be good. is he going now? Well, I suppose this is roughly the right direction of the Skull Village. Oh. Pork. Ha ha. Been a while since I had a good pork chop. Thanks. All right, friend. Well, you're on your own. I got places to go. These creatures seem kind of simple in terms of their culture. They seem a bit primitive and being somewhat territorial is probably natural. So Etienne's kind of the mind that being territorial on their part is perfectly reasonable. So rather than inviting conflict by running straight through their encampment. Oh, here we go. Let's try and make him believe he is... Imagination was getting the better of him, eh? Finish it. Wow. We're learning some interesting little tidbits about these creatures and their tactics. Taking some more of that boar meat. This poor bastard. Food. We'll take the meat. What is that? Is it a reekling skull? It doesn't... I think it's hilarious they put the hat on it. What's this? Fur helmet. On a yam. They got a sense of humor, I'll give them that. Thank you. Nasty little bastards, though. Gonna take your stuff, though. Can we be done with this now? Is that a flag up there? On the back side of that same camp. Okay, our instincts are telling us that up here near this flag, there's something deceased. It's one of the creatures. A spigot. Interesting. They appear to be like pack rats. Is that bear sleeping? I think it is. Alright, we've made a great big circle. Back to where we were. Unfortunately, that wandering skull took us off the beaten path a little bit. I wasn't expecting to run into him, and Ettient felt a little bit responsible. Something has already scavenged the bodies of our dead trolls, too. Probably some of those creatures.
Man.
Alright, let's get our bearings here. I'm not sure that I'm on the same track I was when I came. Am I? Got a little bit lost. I think I may be a little bit further down the mountain than I was last time.
Let's go back and get in. I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
Yeah, this is where we were.
Oh, that treasure.
Oh. Whoa. Stay on her. Die. Die already. Oh, man. Is there another one? Or did she turn that fox against us, maybe? Okay, let's get the hell out of here. All right, now we're on the right track. We've come all the way back to the village. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for joining me on this leg of the journey. In the next episode, we are going to scout out that shrine and then see what we need to do to eliminate it. We're going to try and do these Skull a favor in hopes that maybe they can help us actually find who we're looking for. I'll see you next time.